Hey everybody, CPO from Maybe I'm Amazed, back with my friend Antoine Arvisu from the Compound Studio here in Long Beach. We're checking out the Wings at the Speed of Sound album, and today's track that we're going to listen to is first track on side one. It's called Silly Love Songs.
Side two.
All right, here we go with Silly Love Songs. Let's check it out.
Around me.
man. What's wrong with that?
Nothing wrong with that.
Silly love songs.
Nothing wrong with that.
So this song, I think this song is so ironic because it's called Silly Love Songs, right? Sure. Which is such a dismissive title almost. Mm-hmm. And this song is so complicated.
Right.
This song is so complicated. This is one we play live. And I got to say, this is the hardest song to play bass and sing because that the bass line is just, it's
now
intense.
Now on the Wings Over America, is Paul playing bass?
Yeah.
Who's playing piano?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know because I think...
Maybe he just skips the piano? Yeah. The piano's a pretty big part.
Right. The video that I've seen is just, it's mainly on him, so...
Yeah, but he's playing bass and singing.
I think Denny's playing keys on this one, but... But there's a lot of strings going on,
mm-hmm.
and I don't remember that. Do you guys remember in the Wings Over America if that's going on? I don't remember.
Definitely horns. They got horns in the band.
Yeah, for sure. The horns are covering most of it.
The horns are cooking.
No, I think there was. I think there's a little bit of a. I think there's like a mellotron type of sound going on for the strings instead.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, there's everything about this song is complicated. You've got the vocal round at the end of the song.
Yeah.
I mean, there's three different parts and they're all working together so well.
And it's nearly 6 minutes long.
Yeah.
And yet it doesn't feel like that.
Right.
I mean, I know we were sitting here, maybe people got tired of watching us bop for 6 minutes, but it seems there's a logical progression.
It's all interesting.
Yeah. It just keeps going. Yeah. Keeps going. I imagine there's a single version that they put together for the radio because that's a lot of music to play on the radio.
I don't know.
Back in the day.
I don't know. I haven't heard it.
There may be a single version.
If you guys know of a single version, please link it down in the comments.
Yeah.
Because you're good about that.
But, everything works. Everything works. Everything's working.
Yeah, man. The drums are just real subdued the whole time. Just holding it down.
It's mostly that bass and that piano.
Uh huh.
The horns, of course, but.
So what piano? I didn't really hear piano.
Oh man, piano throughout.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe I wasn't hearing.
And the nice thing again about the way that it's recorded. In fact, this is the first one that maybe I'm wrong, but it seems like where he's actually on a real piano rather than he's been using that Fender Rhodes this whole record.
Yeah.
And this is a piano. But it's pretty subtle and it's pretty spaced out.
Yeah.
As I say that, I think there was another one on this record where he did the same thing. It's a kind of a subtle tone and it's really wide. It's like wide in the speakers. You hear like, you know, the low and the high like this.
Yeah.
There's a lot of room in between to put other instruments. But
the bass is just kind of primary.
And the bass is right down the middle. And there's no fuzzy guitar on this one.
I was going to say, I don't hear guitar at all.
Electric
in the song.
Guitar.
Yeah, I was listening for it. Yeah. I was like, maybe in those little breakdown section, I thought I heard maybe like a wah.
Mm-hmm.
And I think there was some like congas or something.
Oh, yeah. Great percussion stuff
some
throughout.
Percussion going on over here.
What's that thing at the beginning?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Kong. Right. What the heck was all that?
Yeah.
Beating on some metal and stuff like that.
Like loops.
And again, Linda coming through.
Yeah.
You know,
she sounds great on this
Linda
song.
Coming through. Jeez.
I know some people don't like this song though.
Well, like,
it's a throwaway.
Sure, you know.
And I was asking the last time I listened to this song on Wings Over America. I'm like, why didn't he play this song live? Like he kind of stopped playing the song live.
Oh, in later years?
Yeah.
Like in the aughts when he came back and did
all
the
big hits.
You
would think he would do it at least a couple of times.
He never did it, huh? Wow.
No,
it's kind of a, it seems like it's a big, like, you know.
Totally. It's a single.
It seems like a great, like, festival type song.
Totally.
You know?
Never does it. I think it was like 81, maybe 80, 79, like, or right around there when he stopped doing it.
Yeah.
I don't know. It might have even been before that.
Now, was he doing Let Him In more recent years?
I don't know. I think that's been I think he even did that at Glastonbury.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's, I don't know. That's, but I think maybe it's because of because Linda's not there.
Oh.
Because her vocal is so prominent.
So prominent. Yeah.
I don't know.
Maybe so.
You know, some people have said, "Oh, it's because it's too difficult."
Mm.
I'm like, no, man.
Yeah, he'll figure it out.
He can still play it.
He'll figure it out.
He can still play it.
Yeah.
But
it is one rolling bass line.
Yeah, this is one that, you know, it's, I think it's kind of polarizing whether people like it or not. I'm on the side of loving this song. Mm-hmm. I think it's great.
Like I said, once I grew up enough to appreciate this album, as I said in one of the earlier videos, when I got this record, I was a 13-year-old coming off of Band on the Run and Rock Show and all that rock and roll, and I really wasn't ready for the subtlety. But by the time I hit like 19, 20 years old and I rediscovered it, I've been loving it ever since.
You know, yeah. I gotta say, like, I'm kind of in your shoes,
mm-hmm.
like when you were 13,
yeah.
except that I'm older and yeah. more, you know, I'm a little more wiser than a 13-year-old. But there's something about it being such a subtle record that mm-hmm. I'm like I'm so used to things rocking
yeah.
up to this point that yeah. I'm like, hey, wait a minute.
Yeah.
You know?
It really is. It's but a really at the same time, subdued
I'm,
album.
Yeah, but at the same time, I'm cool with it.
I'm cool so, with it.
Yeah. I think it sounds great. It's sonically, it's really nice.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of ear candy going on.
Mm-hmm.
So, cool, man. So, give us your comments, guys. Anything that you guys know? What's the latest that he performed this song live? I would like a link of that video in the comments. So please hook us up with that. And any other things that you guys might have noticed, the guitar, like,
Is there a guitar?
I want to know that. And then overall, what you guys think about this song. So make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell so you'll know when we're coming out with the next one. And just like always, everybody, peace and love.
Peace and love. I love